Hello, everyone. Welcome to a brand new week on Sunrise. Thanks for joining us. We have a very busy morning ahead, including the PM's approval slumps to the lowest level since he got the job. Anthony Albanese now level with Peter Dutton just a day after he postponed his wedding.
But first, to breaking news out of Melbourne, and wild weather is wreaking havoc with overnight gusts reaching almost 100 k's per hour. We cross live to Tegan Dowling, who's right there in Kensington this morning. Tegan, Victorians being advised to stay sheltered and work from home today.
Yeah, now, as you know, we've had that real wave of wild winds over the last week since Tuesday, but last night was very much the worst of it. We have seen gusts of more than 100 kilometres an hour, and it's widespread this morning from all the way Geelong all the way down to places like Frankston. We're seeing more than 100 kilometre an hour gusts, and this is what people are waking up to this morning. Damage like this. We're in Kensington, so we're just outside of the CBD. Huge branches fallen down on people's cars. That blue car under there you can see is totaled, and it's also falling over the fence of this woman's house here. Luckily, it has missed her house, but gee, it would have been a frightening night and morning to wake up to that this morning. Also, a lot of people without power this morning, and this is widespread across Victoria. I've seen on social media in Hamilton, out in the country's west, the state's west, all the way down to Narre Warren, people are without power this morning. Since Tuesday, there's been more than 4,000 calls for help to the SES. Three quarters of them have been for things like we've got here behind us, for trees down this morning. They are going to be inundated. And as you said, the advice from the experts this morning, from the Bureau of Meteorology, from the SES, is that if you can stay at home this morning, do stay at home, because we are seeing this cold front move across. If you can work from home remotely, do that. Also, Nat, we've seen quite a lot of schools decide to close down this morning, because we're actually right at the front of the Kensington Primary School here at the moment. That's to try and keep, obviously, their kids and staff safe, and they'll be going back to remote learning today.
Gee, that is a massive area, isn't it, Tegan? We'll cross back to you soon. Here's Shervo.
Thank you, Nat. In breaking news, an armed gang is on the run after going on a crime spree across Sydney's eastern suburbs overnight. Let's go live to Sunrise correspondent Liam Tapper. Liam, what were they after?
Yeah, morning, Shervo. You can only imagine they were after one thing and one thing only, and cash is what that is. And they were successful when they came here to the Pier Hotel down in Banks Meadow. I'll take you down here. Just about 200 metres down the road, there is Port Botany. So there would have been a lot of people who were here at the pier last night after work on a Sunday night, and inside is where these three men have broken into. Three of them, they were all wearing balaclavas. Two were armed with sawn-off shotguns. One had a knife. Now, they fled here at around 10:30 after they left with that cash. Fortunately, no one was injured, but it wasn't the first job that they tried during the night. Earlier, at the South End Hotel in Maroubra, these three men, they tried to break into that hotel too, but they failed as it was locked. They'd also tried, apparently, I've been told by police, that they tried the South End at Maroubra last week, but they were also unsuccessful there too. Now, after they had left here in Banks Meadow, there was police, they started a pursuit. Unfortunately, though, a police car has crashed into an innocent member of the public, so they weren't able to continue the chase. Fortunately, no one was injured there, Shervo, but these three men this morning, they remain on the run.
OK, very brazen. Thank you, Liam.
With more news now, here's Mon.
Thank you, Nat. Good morning. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has taken another hit to his approval rating in the latest news poll. Let's go live to political reporter Rob Scott, who's in Canberra. Now, Rob, despite the slump, the PM is still ahead of Peter Dutton.
Yeah, he is, mine. And this is a poll that was taken during the heated Palestinian visa debate last month. And the results show that Anthony Albanese's approval rating has fallen 2 points to 41%, which is the equal lowest since he became the Prime Minister. But he does remain ahead of Peter Dutton, who is on 39%. And now, in terms of the two-party preferred contest, that is tied at 50-50. And when it comes to who voters think would make a better Prime Minister, well, Mr Albanese remains ahead 45 to 37%. And with the cost of living still the most pressing issue in Australians' minds, we are starting to see a bit of a shift in the Treasurer's language over who's to blame for their pain, with new GDP data out in a couple of days expected to show very weak economic growth. Jim Chalmers says that interest rate rises are, quote, smashing the economy. So clearly shifting some of the responsibility onto the Reserve Bank, which, interestingly, is something that he has been at pains to avoid in the past. Mon?
Yes, he has. All right. Thank you very much, Rob Scott, for us in Canberra. A major air and sea search mission is getting back underway this morning for a missing teenager in waters off Granite Island in South Australia. Live to Hayden Nelson now. Now, Hayden, what's the latest on this search?
Mon, that search is due to resume this morning for that 17-year-old who disappeared off Granite Island late yesterday afternoon. He's now been missing for more than 12 hours, and there are serious concerns from authorities. He was last seen face down in the water, and search crews, including two helicopters and two search boats, were brought in, but that search was called off last night. Any search this morning will be hampered by the conditions in South Australia at the moment. Wind gusts of up to 100 kilometres an hour were recorded in some parts of the state last night, and there are some huge swells that searchers will have to contend with. So at this stage, we're waiting to hear exactly how they'll approach that this morning, Mon.
All right, Hayden, thank you. The shocking contrast between time served by young Queensland criminals and adults committing the same offences has been exposed in alarming new statistics. We cross live now to Liam Bland, who's on the Gold Coast for us. Liam, morning. This is throwing fresh fuel on that raging debate over the state's crime crisis.
Yeah, good morning, Mon. That's right. These stats reveal that only a fraction of young offenders here in Queensland who are being sentenced for committing the most serious of offences are spending time in detention compared to their adult counterparts. Those stats are from the state government. It revealed that in the case of grievous bodily harm, only about 25% of youths are spending time in detention after sentencing compared to 84% of adults. It's a similar story too for serious assaults, with 90% of adults jailed compared to just 14% of young offenders. It's prompted the LNP to double down on its commitment to hand adult punishments to kid criminals who commit these serious offences if it wins October's state election. The Premier has accused the opposition of cherry-picking these statistics and says there has actually been a decrease in youth crime across Queensland since new measures were put in place. But whether or not that's enough to convince Queenslanders who head to the polls next month, we'll have to wait until election time.
Yep. All right. Liam Bland for us there. Thank you. George Clooney has heaped praise on Joe Biden for stepping down as the Democratic presidential candidate to make way for Kamala Harris. Live to US correspondent Miley Hogan. Now, Miley, what did the Hollywood heavyweight have to say about this?
Mon, he has described Joe Biden's decision to end his re-election bid as selfless. George Clooney is not just a heavy hitter in Hollywood, he's also a heavy hitter in US politics. He is a lifelong Democrat and he helps them raise millions of dollars. But around 2 months ago, he went off script and he wrote an opinion piece for the New York Times. In it, he was quite scathing of Joe Biden, saying that they were not going to win this election with him as their nominee. He did go on to say that the one battle he cannot win is the fight against time. None of us can. Now, he has not spoken about the impact of that piece until now. Take a listen to what he had to say.
What should be remembered is the selfless act of someone who, you know, it's very hard to let go of power. You know, we know that. We've seen it, you know, all around the world. And for someone to say, I think there's a better way forward, that's all the credit goes to him.
George Clooney there next to his co-star Brad Pitt. They're at the Venice Film Festival promoting their new film. But, of course, he has been asked about that piece and his opinion on Joe Biden's decision to quit the race. Mon.
OK, Miley, thank you. Fans of Australia's favourite blue heeler can finally get their hands on special limited edition bluey coins today. And getting in the queue at Australia Post early is Jordan Bissell. Jordan, these are real-life dollar bucks and they won't last long.
That's right. Welcome to the home of Bluey. I'm in Brisbane CBD at the moment, and this is the day that all Bluey fans have been waiting for months now. Those limited edition $1 dollar bucks will go on sale from this morning when Australia Post opens its doors at 8:30. There are 10 collectible $1 coins available, as well as an exclusive stamp pack. Now, there will be some rare coloured coins hidden in some packs. Those are also available online too, so keep an eye out for those. But these aren't the same as the rare coin collection, which was released earlier this year. That was resold online the same day as its release for more than six times the original price. Now, those were in such high demand, we saw 63,000 of them stolen in July from a Sydney warehouse. Police even set up a special task force called Strike Force Bandit before they arrested two men over those. So certainly a real craving for those there.
Indeed they are. They're super cute too. All right, Jordan, thank you.